Scientists often say that within 5 to 10 billion years, the world will come to an end. But how exactly will that happen? It's pretty hard to imagine our entire planet and all human life not existing. Well, according to scientists, there are 4 ways the Earth will actually end. Today we're going to look at those 4 ways and find out the most likely way the world will end. I'm Charlie, and today we're going to look at how the world will end. But before it does, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? So, the first way the world will end is human extinction. When it comes to the end of the world, there have been many predictions. Just take the Mayan calendar saying the world will end in 2012. Some scientists even say a supervolcano may take us out, or a big asteroid. But remember, these are all predictions. However, the extinction of humans is not just a prediction, it's an inevitability. Look at the news and you'll see many headlines saying, "We have too many people on Earth." After all, we have 7.5 billion people, so where will humans go? But remember, humans have only been around for under 1 million years. That is, in our current form. Slowly, over hundreds of thousands of years, humans will change. And as the Earth changes, different species die out. We often see this with animals, but barely ever think of it with us. So that's why many scientists say that within millions of years, humans won't be around any longer. We already have a rapidly changing planet with limited resources. For example, nuclear, chemical, or biological weapons are all things which could take us out. And there's also many natural pressures we face, for example, diseases. So, whether it's a supervolcano or an asteroid or something more natural like a disease, humans will be wiped out. That will be the end of the world for humans. But just because we're not on it doesn't mean our Earth isn't there. So, let's look at another way the world will end. And that is boiling oceans. That's right, the Earth's oceans boiling. Many people don't realize this, but it's a massive coincidence our planet is at the distance it is from a star exactly as massive as our own. This allows our planet to support life. And of course allows our planet to have water, which is very uncommon for other planets in our solar system. For billions of years, the Earth and the Sun have been totally compatible. But as time goes on, the Sun will have massive changes. And thanks to the evolution of our Sun, our oceans won't be around for much longer. Right now, helium is building up in the Sun's core. This is the area of the Sun where nuclear fusion occurs. And as this expands, it will have terrible consequences for our planet. The Sun is heating up at all times, expanding and emitting more power. And scientists say that in about 1 billion years, the Sun will be giving off so much energy that we won't be able to handle it. And scientists say that within a few million years, the Sun's temperature will get too hot for planet Earth. This high energy will hit the water molecules in the Earth's oceans. And this will effectively boil our oceans. As that happens, our atmospheres will fill with water vapor, but not like the kind you get from vape pens. Instead, this will be a very dangerous greenhouse gas causing the Earth's temperature to rise. Earth will then be more like Venus. And of course, this means it will be totally inhospitable to any life form at all. Next up, we have Reduction to Rock. Reduction to Rock sounds like an awesome band, but it isn't. It's actually one of the ways our world will end. Scientists say that eventually every atom of our atmosphere will be ejected from planet Earth, and the entire world's surface will be reduced to rock and charred ash. Every living creature and plant will be turned to dust. You may think this sounds like science fiction, but this really did happen to a planet in our solar system, Mercury. Mercury is the closest planet to the Sun, and in around 5 billion years, that's what will happen to Earth. You see, the Sun is running out of hydrogen fuel in its core. And when that happens, the core will heat up and fuse helium. You may think of helium as the chemical which allows you to speak in a high voice.
Kind of like this.
But inside the Sun, it will release more energy than ever before. This will turn the Sun from its current state to a gigantic burning red star. And sadly, little old Earth won't be able to withstand this and will perish. In around 5 billion years, the Sun will be 100 times its current diameter, and thousands of times brighter than it is today. This will mean every atom will be pushed out of our atmosphere on Earth, and planets which are already close to the Sun like Mercury and Venus will be totally destroyed. After Earth has been roasted by the Sun will reduce to being a white dwarf star. But that's not before it destroys our entire planet as well as Mercury and Venus. And the final fourth way the Earth will end is we will be swallowed or ejected. So even after all life is gone, our oceans are boiled, and the Earth is just a charred crisp, it will still exist. It will be a really hot planet with no life orbiting around a central stellar corpse. That is, until the final way our Earth will be totally wiped out forever, and it will either be swallowed or ejected. Basically, one of the following three things will happen. Either an object will collide with Earth, destroying it or engulfing it. This depends on the size and speed of the collision. This could happen at any time, as the universe literally goes on forever. That is, until a Google amount of years. Google is an incredibly large number. It's one digit followed by 100 zeros. Many scientists say this is the estimated time for the heat death of our universe. Another way our Earth could be totally wiped out is gravity ejecting it from our solar system, and then eventually the galaxy entirely. This would basically shoot our Earth into an empty cosmos for eternity. Or perhaps it would be engulfed by the sun's corpse. And then eventually the sun's corpse, as well as the Earth's corpse, would be swallowed by a black dwarf star. So there we go, that's how Earth will end. Of course, Earth and the galaxy will eventually come to an end, as everything does. But make sure you live life to the fullest now, because you don't currently have to worry about it. Our ancestors, millions or billions of years in the future, will though. So if you're watching this from the future, then sorry, we had it easy. But now it's time to make your opinion heard. How do you think the world will end? Vote in the poll in the top right corner and let me know. If you want some more amazing videos, check out my second channel. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.